The reclamations are the true tribunal. The Daedra that consecrate the Dunmer people. Azura, Methala, and Boethia.
I'm Scott from Fudge Muppet, and today you guys have asked for the Morag Tong Assassin, so that's what you're going to get. Now, first thing to get off my chest, illusion is normally a good idea for assassins, and you'd expect a Morag Tong assassin has illusion. Yet, for this one in particular, I chose to focus on pure combat skills more so. Yet, feel free to add illusion to the build if you like. So, as a pure assassin, two rather typical assassin skills are necessary: sneak and archery. All the sneak perks are needed to escape, cause critical damage, and for those up-close dagger kills. Whereas in archery, you can focus on perks for damage and good aim. The fast draw and arrow recovery isn't necessary, but get it if you have the perks for it. Though for this particular assassin, there is a rather interesting choice of skill, which is two-handed. Now the reason for this is, you might be already predicting it, but is to utilize the Ebony Blade, the Daedric artifact of Mephala, whom is the Daedra worshipped and obeyed by the Morag Tong assassins. All the perks are in the link in the description, so just check that out. The assassin has a pretty typical Morag Tong aesthetic. He or she wears all the Morag Tong armor from the Dragonborn DLC, equipped with the Dwarven Black Bow of Fate, also from the Dragonborn DLC, with ebony arrows, and also wields an ebony blade and also an ebony dagger for those up-close encounters. Now, the reason we picked Dwarven Black Bow of Fate and Ebony Blade as weapons is for survivability due to the absorption effects. So when the Morag Tong assassin has to resort to open confrontation, he can use the Ebony Blade well, which is also used to constantly absorb health and never run out. The other reason for using the Ebony Blade, of course, is that it's Mephala's holy Daedric artifact. Or unholy, rather. The need for this absorption is because it's a rather fun but risky build. I myself placed a majority of my points into stamina, having only 300 health, making it challenging, but the absorption effects help counter that. All the light armor perks are great to have as well, because it will increase survivability, plus you can take advantage of the matched set perks and stamina regeneration. Playstyle wise, it's a straight up assassin. Use a dagger for close quarter stealth kills, and a bow for killing from afar. When in open confrontation, skillfully slice and dice your foes with Mephala's Ebony Blade. Now for roleplaying. First rule, do not, under any circumstances, join the Dark Brotherhood. They are scum to be eradicated. These two factions are mortal enemies, and a Morag Tong assassin joining the Dark Brotherhood kinda breaks immersion. Now I like to play the Morag Tong assassin as a bit of a xenophobic prick, like many traditional Dunmer were, with their slaves and hate of outsiders. This assassin is quite traditional, so he isn't fond of many other races, especially Argonians. Now for a bit of a backstory, the Morag Tong assassin was separated from the rest of his guild when the disasters of Red Mountain and the Argonian invasion occurred. He fled west to Skyrim, under guidance of Mephala. Mephala guides him to the Ebony Blade, and has entrusted him to carry on the Morag Tong traditions and murder in the name of Mephala. So what you want to do is, as soon as you can, go get that Ebony Blade. Thank you for watching this build, I hope you liked it. Remember to like, subscribe, share, and everything you can do to help us out, it's greatly appreciated. Also, follow me on Twitter, I'm far more likely to answer your questions there as it's less clustered than the YouTube comments. And we also have an Instagram, so you can look at pictures of us if that's your jam. So, thank you again, and remember to go to Facebook with the link down below to vote for next week's build. That was the Morag Tong Assassin, I'm Scott, and that's about it. Ciao.